Lighting something on fire and spinning it around your body as best you can without burning yourself or hurting yourself. Benji did this, and that is how I knew Benji. The first time I saw Benji spin fire, and I'm kind of a fire dancer snob, you know, and he made me humble. So thank you, Benji, for lighting it on fire, lighting the world on fire, and just showing people something new and different. Thank you.
My spirit lives on in my friends now. My spirit lives within the earth. My spirit lives on in my loved ones. I am not gone. I'm all around. I am not gone. I'm all around.
So Ben rented my house a few months. So I got to know him when he first came into town, and he was like really shy and kind of seemed to have no sense of self or where he fit in. I wasn't really good friends with him or anything, but I saw him months later with Suzanne, and he was a totally different person. I don't know what kind of fucking magic shit you did. Because he wasn't even like a drinker. He's just like a, you know. But he was happy. Like, he was a happy, happy person. And so I guess that's all I want to say. But whatever you did, he loved you so much. And you let him feel good. And you made him feel good. Thank you for being who you are. I love you.
Benji was a really fun guy. And it took me forever to figure out this guy talking to me on Facebook who he was, Shredrick. I was like, who is this guy in town? Like, we had all these conversations, and I was like, who? And then finally one day I was like, oh.
I know.
I made the connection. But he, you know, and it was like everything. It was about astronauts. It was about, like, you know, circus. It was about fire dancing. It was about whatever, you know, he wanted. He would come up with the craziest things, but it was awesome. Because every time it would end with, like, this, I would feel wonderful things in my heart, not even knowing who this person was I was talking to. someday, you know, I'd wake up and there'd be this funny text from this guy, Shredrick. I don't know. So thank you, Suzanne, for bringing him into our lives and keeping him here and making it lighter and fun.
I'm pretty sure he thought I hated him.
That's a great opener.
And I'm pretty sure I thought I hated him too. But one night, I did something really stupid, and he tried to save my life. And then later on, I yelled at him for it. And I never got to apologize for that. And I so regret it to this day because he carried me to the hospital. And he just wanted a family, and I didn't. I was too stubborn to let him have that because, I don't know, I'm a teenager. So wherever he is, I hope he can see more of his family and his children grow up. Because as much as he wanted a place where he could have children, unfortunately that place wasn't with us because of just so many circumstances, and I wish I would have been more accepting. But he was a genius. And I wish I'd explored that more while I knew him, because I never got a chance to know him because I didn't want to understand him. So I'm sorry to Benji, who might be out there, wherever he is. Yes. So Benji used to say something a lot. He used to say, I never really understood it until today. He used to say, flailing in total darkness. He told me that all the time. I would walk into the kitchen, he'd be like, I'm flailing in total darkness and shit. And I'm like, and I never understood that before. I never understood that before, but now I think I do. Honestly, we all experience sadness in our own way, and maybe others suffer it more than others because you're dealing with other things, and then this happens, and then they're just dying and shit, and they don't know what to do. And we all, in a way, kind of act like we're doing okay. We all come together, be like, okay, I'm here, I'm together. But I think we're all distant mentally anyway. Even if we don't want to be, it's how it is.
Yes.
Because
yes.
We all can't really understand each other completely. And I think Benji, I respect him. Sorry, I'm a little bit all over the place, but I really respected him. You know, I mean, sometimes I'd be a little bit questionable when I walked into the kitchen and I'd always stub my toe on the freaking skateboard that stood in front of the fridge. I'd walk into that kitchen and he'd be freaking skating over to me. I'm like, holy shit. It was really scary. I don't really
scary the more.
But I'm glad you all came here. It really does mean a lot. Even though we really don't know what we're doing anymore, and even though maybe losing Benji is a big part of that, I think that it's important that we always remember that we're all kind of suffering, but we don't have to suffer in silence.
Beautiful.
So I knew Benji mostly through Suzanne, but the biggest takeaway that I got from him was about how he was just an explosive light that burned so brightly with such ferocious energy that you could not ignore if you were trying to. And I feel like Benji's energy was the best of what Bisbee has to offer. Seeing him ride down Main Street in a watermelon with purple tights and just incense smell flowing from his scarves. It was just all the magic that Bisbee has to bring. And I feel like he was kind of an embodiment of the best of us. And
he was so Bisbee.
And I feel like losing him, his energy is now dispersed throughout all of us. And we just got to keep that Bisbee spirit going. And even though through a year like this, that's so fucking hard, that energy is going to help us get through it. And everybody just embody that Bisbee Benji-ness. And yeah, he was awesome, and I'm glad you had him and got to be here for his last time.
Really, out of everything that happened, Benji saved Suzanne's life. And that was, he gifted that to all of us, I think.
Yes, he did.
And I think that's important to acknowledge. Benjamin was fun, he was a good guy, but in his tactical driving from the military and all his fucking weird bullshit that he talked about, that really added up to something, and that's a good thing, and I think we all need to acknowledge that. Hey. Thanks to Benji, he did good. Good driving. Good driving, Benji.
I say, standing cool, ovation for Suzanne.
Yes!
We love you!
Woohoo!
Got a drink? Yep. You'll need it.
It's seltzer right now.
Yeah. Okay.
Sorry.
All right. Well, I just want to start by saying I've never felt more loved in all my life after Benji's death through the outpouring of loved ones, and especially here in Bisbee. I continue to be blown away. Thank you for holding space for me. Thank you for crying for me when I could not, because I didn't know if I could handle it. I didn't know what I was made of for this kind of thing. Thank you for giving me the strength to experience it safely and lovingly, because it's not over yet. My view of life and death changes almost daily. I add to it, I subtract from it. Neuroplasticity reigns for me right now. So I've been writing this over the last week or so. So my views change daily, so just know. Listen, Suzanne, you don't listen. Oh, I listen. It's just that Benji, your memory is on fire for knowledge. Who can compare with that? Always pushing others to do your best, he would say. He would introduce about a word a day I had never heard, just in casual conversation. I think he mentioned his IQ was over 150. I believe it. He was endlessly fascinating to me. I took that handful of a man in exchange for his passion, intellect, and playfulness. His world was big and could hardly contain him. I was in awe of his ability to keep up on so many friends, texting friends all day up until the day before he died. He liked sharing and helping others see other points of view. Moses Malone, we grieve with you. He loves you as a brother. I wish you all the success with your skateboard company in Montana. He derives great joy from inspiring his friends and helping strangers. The afternoon before he left this plane, he jumped out of my car to assist an 18-wheeler backing up from an overhead the trucker could not pass. One of his great passions was caring for plants and animals of all sizes, down to the hummingbird and bumblebee. He said he could never leave me because of my cat, and I believe him. He chided me once for not taking the time to play with babies. Yeah. He wanted many astronaut babies of his own, and was sad that it did not come to fruition. I knew he wanted a harem, but it was just not practical in my 700 square foot home. Right, kids? He was always torn between life on the road, where anything is possible at any moment, which would satisfy his wanderlust, compared to the comforts of a stable home. We domesticated well together, and my family is better for it.
Now I have 15 chickens, hummingbirds to feed, and greenhouse plants to water. I also have his man shed to finish. I have tools now and a greater ability to build and fix things. What I found super sexy, ready? Wait for it. Was his ability to maneuver around a laptop. Especially with arms around me on the keyboard, as in the pottery wheel seen on the movie Ghost, my version. I am less afraid to push buttons and figure stuff out on my own now, thanks to him. He would say, 3 years of engineering school, what do you expect? It is hard, you're right, he's an engineer. It is hard to be super sad when you feel his presence most of the time. I have even felt him inside of me, looking through my eyes with me in my car driving. The other night, I decided to pick up his flute, and I asked him to play through me, and I played flute for the first time, and I was able to carry tunes, which I could never do before. Thank you for that proof. I believe his soul and spirit, for when the soul moves on, is ever expanding. I believe he can finally visit all the people he loves and could not prior, especially with COVID. I feel so blessed to have had him to play with during the recent lockdown. I told him, let's make this the time of our lives, and we did. I truly feel he is at peace and he's actually happy now. I prayed hard that he would find where he needs to go and not be lost, especially after a tragic death. At first, I think he was a little lost coming to his old abode, Bree. Breathing heavy.
That was creepy, Ben.
It was creepy. Ben, breathing labored at the door.
Hey, man, I don't know. I'm an instrument. That's crazy.
He was looking. Hey, I came to you right after the accident. Dead. I walked right to our house from the ER, so we all came to you, Bree. Love you, man. You helped me out so much.
That's amazing.
I even experienced the nothingness underneath the thin veneer of this life, and it was dark. Maybe I was feeling it with him, but I don't feel that way anymore. I think his spirit is becoming accustomed to this birth after death. Death is a sacred rite of passage, respect to the Grim Reaper. It is holy, let us not forget. I believe he has maneuvered it well. Some say he lived a lifetime in 36 years. He was a force in this world, a gift to this realm. I believe not content being contained in this human meat suit, as he would say. This week I had a thought, if our spirit is always with us, even after death, then why don't we expand more consciously while living? I realize how dense the human body really is, and I'm curious to know how to grow beyond current limitations. Benji was a good lesson in how to do so, as he often talked in a mysterious, magical, riddled way that insulted basic communication. All who have known him, I believe, will grow exponentially upon understanding his messages, even the dark ones, maybe more so for those who knew him very well. Even more so than his friends, Benji shall live on through his children, Penelope and Jack. My heart goes out to them. My heart goes out to all his family and friends who he touched. What I wish to take away from this Benjamin Joseph Safford experience is a love for all plants and animals and babies. To be better at keeping up with family and friends and letting them know how much I care about them. Continued thirst for knowledge, diving deep. A quest for new music that is pitch perfect and meaningful. I'm such a music snob. The importance of dance for the soul. A greater love and appreciation for my children, really being with them. A greater awareness of politics and the environment, and a more vocal passion for what I believe. And of course, how to make love while in love. I felt as though my chakras would all light up when I was near him sometimes, and my body would pulsate in places from a mere holding hands or lips closed without kissing. We would do Reiki dancing. You could say he set my soul on fire. He was goofy as shit and had a beautiful, deep, lingering laugh. I had an epiphany early on after he passed that we birthed a little girl and that little girl was me. He brought me Matchbox cars for Christmas because he knew I played with them as a child and he wanted to connect to my inner child. He also called me Susie, my childhood name. Those cars are still all around my house and he would put them in different places to surprise me. his world with skateboards. We had like 5 longboards all over the house to trip on, balance on, skate on, and yoga on. He even had a skateboard yoga class for a brief stint. Thank you, Sonia, for tolerating. Thank you, Robin, for being the only class participant. You have to come out and tell us how it was. Yeah, thank you. He taught me how to skate, and we did so very regularly, mostly the hills of Warren. Some tough hills are now easy for me, thanks to him, and I continue to skate in his memory and for my enjoyment. He said, I'm getting older, so I need to know how to fall. Thank you, Benji, for this new hobby, and my balance has never been better. His ex-wife mentioned that she felt he was finally starting to grow up and credits that to me. She said that it's too bad we will not see the blossoming of that growth. It appears we balanced each other, I believe. After all, he was 14 inches taller.
I love you, Suzanne!
And 14 years younger. I do miss him reaching for things for me. I don't know if this helps anyone, but I feel obliged to tell you what I know.
Cliffhanger.
Sorry.
I love you.
I believe his subconscious knew of the impending situation. Months before he died, he cleaned up loose ends and contacting people and finishing songs for them and telling them that he did not hate them. He also bought a dash cam July 9th for my car that recorded the accident. The dash cam recorded the accident, and now I have a court date on October 9th for vehicular manslaughter. Thank you, Benji, for making that easy. He had a dream 2 years prior while in Rochester, New York, and shared it with Kathy, who lived there at the time. They had just met, which makes this even more odd. This is the dream he shared with her. I had such a weird dream last night, pretty unique as far as my dreams go. The thing I remember most clearly was that I was wearing these heavy welding gloves, and this super aggressive rabbit latched onto my right hand. Through the glove, it felt like my hand was in a vise. I remember trying to hit it with a wrench and trying to let it go. Then I woke up. The gloves I remember were very new. I could smell the leather. The rabbit in this dream was decisively male, though, like an aggressive buck rabbit, just latched on furiously. We hit a welding truck, and we veered to the right. Yeah. It's haunting. I don't question death. Respect death. So that's what makes it actually easier, like in a weird warped way, you know? I don't know if you get that, but I'll have some. Yeah.
Yes.
Thank you. Yeah.
Fuck yes.
Yeah, there's nothing we can do. Yeah. He would say, once you see it, you can't unsee it. I think he meant the magic. I think that is a good thing to remember. Nothing's really tragic unless you loved it first. I think that is a good thing to remember. I love Benji with all my heart, beyond tragic. He was a part of me now and dead only in the physical realm. I'd like to look at the world through his eyes sometimes, unless tripping balls. That's too much. I've said for years that with every death there is a gift. Look for the gift. Now I believe the bigger the death, the bigger the gift or gifts. Why limit ourselves? Sometimes they are epiphanies and sometimes more substantial concrete things that can happen in our lives. Benji has said, Suzanne, I'm going to leave you better than how I found you. Okay, Ben.
That's pretty fucking amazing. That's pretty Woo! Fucking amazing.
I think he left all of... I think that helped me get a lawyer, to be honest. I told him that. He's like, oh, I'll take the case. I think he left us all of us, with a sense of playfulness and stressed the importance of that quite regularly. We need people like Benji to remind us that life is shorter than you may like, so play. Play like a child at times, even if it takes matchbox cars to remind you. If you look at people as if they are children, you are more likely to forgive, which eases any pain someone may bring on to you. His being was a gift to me. Even the dark stuff I am finding is a gift in the depth of lessons I will garner for many years to come. I am glad I took a chance on this handful of a man, the big, gorgeous, playful wizard, this man who opened me up and laid me bare, body, mind, and soul. Even the accident, you could say, represented the last flip on the roller coaster. I see the beauty in everything, and that is why it is hard to be deeply sad, and I hope I will continue to remember the beauty. Friends, please remind me of this when I need it.
Oh, I will.
I'm crying, Bill.
I'm crying. Sorry. But I will, and you know that.
An old friend of mine last night said, Suzanne, I see Leon through your eyes. He died 15 years ago. Maybe his spirit is helping me through this experience. That is validation that those we love can live on in us.
I know he is.
I got a heckler. Who has a heckler at a memorial service?
I'll shut the fuck up.
No, I love you both.
I promise I won't say another thing.
You're lucky I'm not a comic. You'd be out of here.
I'll just keep crying.
You're awesome. I love you, Bill.
He just wants to hug you.
Yeah. Okay, so friends, let's take a moment of silence and let what you need or choose to sink in a little deeper. And let us consummate by consuming Ben's favorite affordable bourbon whiskey and raise our glass to toast this man and honor the life that he lived most fully. And let the best bits live on in us and through us. And the not so good bits live on in the form of valuable lessons for us all, at least for me. Rest in peace, my love. You are my angel now.
That was beautiful. That was lovely.
Oh my God, Suzanne.
Who wants to help me?
I'm coming.
It's like a wedding, only different.
That was gorgeous. Really, really beautiful. And heartfelt, and it's gorgeous.
And his spirit is always with us if we so choose.
Wait.
He will not die in vain, goddammit. Everyone take a little piece of Ben, integrate it into them so that we won't, so I won't especially, miss him so damn much. Okay? Thank you. Hiya.
Salute.
He wanted a dance party more than anything. Aww. And I felt so bad. Like, then COVID, whatever. So, we're going to give him a dance party. If you're leaving, sign the back of the skateboard, and this is going to be placed on the highway where he was last seen.
Oh,
Carolyn,
hell yeah.
Carolyn Toronto painted this angel yesterday and today, and I got the accoutrements. And they happen to match.
It's fantastic. It looks amazing.
It's beautiful. So, there's markers here. Feel free to sign the back. And, yeah, so there you go.
Can we do
it? I just
I made it over 2 days later.
And here's Kathy and Tim.
Yeah. Let me know if you need to. Oh my
God.
She didn't need anything because she's Suzanne. She was fine.
Right, yeah, she was right.
I made it over 2 days later.
Play a tune for Benji. The thing that I sticks out to my mind about Benji is whenever I would see him, he would greet me and he'd say, today is the day of days. He'd say, it's the day of days. And that was, and then he'd hand me some incense and I'd stick it on my bicycle and drive around.
Take me a feather and blow it away.
go. You give all you have to offer. There's nothing left to hold and nothing left to stop for. Give all you had to offer.